Good morning all of you. Okay, today we will see the last video of the unit 2, okay, that is the steam boilers. Okay, in case of second unit, okay, this is the last topic. Okay, in this video, okay, we will see, okay, what are the different types of boilers. Okay, see here, it is a simple vertical boiler. Here I am showing a simple vertical boiler. Okay, in case of a vertical boiler, the shell of the boiler is vertical. The axis of the shell is, boiler shell is, okay, vertical. And see here, okay, you can observe, okay, type of boiler is having, okay, different boiler mountings and boiler axles. Okay, see here a pressure gauge. Okay, it is a boiler mounting. Okay, with the help of boiler mountings, we are operating the boiler under safe working condition. With the help of this pressure gauge, we are reading the generated steam pressure, and through this manhole, we are checking the inside parts of the boiler, and we can made repairs and we can made cleanings also. Okay, with the help of water gauge, okay, we are reading the level of water inside the boiler shell, and if there is less water inside the boiler shell, we have to compensate the water level, or we have to reduce the supply of heat to the feedward. And see here, it is a feasible plug. Okay, with the help of feasible plug, we are regulating the, okay, availability of heat energy to the, okay, feed water. And in case of hand hose and fire hole, okay, we are introducing the, okay, coal into the, okay, boiler combustion chamber. Okay, here this is the feed check valve. Okay, with the help of feed check valve, okay, we can check the flow rate of water into the boiler shell. Okay, see here, inside the boiler shell, we are generating the hot flue gases. The hot flue gases are flowing over the tube. And inside the tube, we are circulating the water. That means, this is the one type of water tube boiler. Okay, over the tube, we are made to flow the hot flue gases. Inside the tubes, we are made to flow the, okay, water. So, it is a water tube boiler. And in case of grate, we are introducing the, okay, coal onto the grate. And on the grate, we are melting the coal inside the boiler combustion chamber. Okay. In case of cross box, we are arranging the number of horizontal tubes for increasing the heat transfer area, and cylindrical shell is the boiler shell. And in case of steam space, we are generating the steam. Okay, from the steam space, we are collecting the steam, and with the help of safety valve, we are releasing the excess pressure generated by the steam inside the boiler section. Okay, through the chimney, after utilizing the gases, generated gases energy in the boiler shell, okay, we are introducing that hot flue gases into the outside atmosphere. Okay, this type of boiler we are using in, okay, stationary type of power plants. Okay, like food processing units and chemical processes also, we are using this type of boiler for smaller applications. Okay, this vertical shell, the shell of the boiler is vertical and attached to the bottom of the furnace. The shell is attached to the bottom of the furnace. We see in the figure, greater portion of the shell is full of water which surrounds the furnace. Okay, inside the shell, we are placing the water, and the furnace releases the hot flue gases. One or more cross tubes are, okay, either riveted or flanged to the furnace to increase the heat transfer surface and improve the water circulation. Okay, with the help of that cross tubes, we are circulating the water. And in case of combustion of coal takes place in the furnace, okay, inside the firebox only we are made to burn the fuels, and with the help of burning fuels, we are generating the heat energy. Okay, that heat energy is supplied to the feed water. Okay, the feed water is circulating through the cross tubes, and during the flow of hot flue gases over the cross tubes, okay, feed water is heated and converted into steam. Okay, that generated steam enters into the steam space. From the steam space, we are collecting the steam. Okay, steam is we are using in our applications. Okay, see the next type of boiler, Cochrane boiler. Okay, next one is Cochrane boiler. Okay, see the diagram of Cochrane boiler. Okay, in this diagram I mentioned clearly the different parts of Cochrane boiler. Okay, see the cylindrical shell. CS is the cylindrical shell. This is the cylindrical shell and combustion chamber. Okay, this is combustion chamber. Okay, inside the combustion chamber we are generating the gases. That gases are flowing through the tubes. Okay, see the gases are flowing through the tubes. Okay, so this type of boiler is a fire tube boiler. Okay, this type of boiler is a fire tube boiler. Okay, inside the furnace we are generating the combustion products, and the combustion products we are introducing into the inside the tubes of the boiler, and the tubes are submerged in the water level. Okay, then that water is heated and that water will becomes converting into steam. Okay, that generated steam we are using in our application. Okay, through the steam space we are collecting that generated steam. See, the generated steam, okay, we are collecting through the steam stop valve and with the help of pressure gauge. Similarly, okay, we are using pressure gauge in order to indicate the generated steam pressure, and we are using water level indicator in order to indicate the level of water inside the boiler combustion chamber. And it is constructed with bricks and in case of SB means, okay, smoke box. Okay, through the smoke box we are collecting the hot flue gases, and we are introducing that hot flue gases into the chimney, through the chimney into the outside atmosphere. Okay, we are using this type of boiler for medium pressure applications. Okay, medium pressure applications we are using this type of boiler. Okay, see here also we are using boiler mountings and boiler accessories. Okay, mostly in high pressure boilers we are using the boiler accessories, all boiler accessories. Okay, in case of medium pressure and low pressure boilers we are using only feed water pump. Only feed water pump we are using as a boiler accessory. And in case of all boilers, smaller capacity, medium capacity and high pressure capacity, we require to adapt boiler mountings. All boiler mountings we have to adapt. See here also we are adapted as all boiler mountings. Okay, pressure gauge, steam stop valve, steam step safety valve and manhole and smoke box, fire box, all are boiler mountings. Feed water pump and feed check valve, all these are the boiler mountings. With the help of boiler mountings only we can operate the boiler under safe working condition. Okay, you can observe the construction of this type of boiler, Cochrane boiler. Okay, inside the tubes we are generating the combustion products by burning of coal in the boiler combustion chamber. The combustion products we are introducing into the tubes of the boiler. Inside the tubes the combustion products are flowing and the tubes are submerged in the water. Okay, because of hot flue energy, okay, the hot flue gases energy we are using to heat the feed water, and feed water is converted into steam. Okay, in case of Cochrane boiler it is a vertical and internally fired boiler, natural circulation and fire tube boiler. Okay, fire tube boiler means hot flue gases are flowing inside the tubes, and in case of vertical boiler that means the shell of the boiler is vertical. Internally fired means the gases are generated inside the boiler combustion chamber. Natural circulation means we are not using any feed water pump. Okay, naturally we are circulating the water based on the level difference. Okay, that type of boiler is Cochrane boiler. Okay, boiler may be coal fired or oil fired. We are using coal as fuel in case of Cochrane boiler. Okay, several horizontal tubes to increase the heating surface. In the diagram also we observed, okay, so many horizontal tubes arranged in order to increase the heat transfer area. Okay, in order to increase the more flow rate of water. Okay, the coal is introduced through the fire door onto the grate. On the grate is a PL bed. Okay, on the PL bed we are introducing the PL and we are burning the PL on the PL bed. From the PL bed we are generating the hot flue gases. Okay, PL burned in the firebox and hot gases from the firebox passed to the combustion chamber. Okay, from the combustion chamber, okay, the hot flue gases enters into the tubes of the boiler section and through the thickness of the tubes, the gaseous energy is transferred to the water and water will become converting into steam. After generating the steam, after utilizing the gaseous energy, the gases are escaped into the outside atmosphere through the chimney. See the next type of boiler. Next type of boiler is Babcock and Wilcox boiler. In case of Babcock and Wilcox boiler, we are seeing the diagram. See here. This is the boiler drum. And we are arranging the boiler tubes inclinedly. From the boiler drum, we are collecting the water from the upper header to the lower header. Here we are arranging the tubes inclinedly. Because of gravitational force only, water is circulated naturally. It is also natural circulation type of water, natural circulation type of boiler, and the hot flue gases flows over the tubes and water flows inside the tubes. That means it is a water tube boiler, natural circulation type water tube boiler. The hot flue gases generated is outside the furnace. That means it is an externally fired boiler. This type of boiler also we are using in medium pressure applications. See the boiler mountings. This is the water level indicator. This is pressure gauge. This is boiler drum to accommodate the water. This is the hot flue gases passes. And these are the different horizontal tubes, inclined tubes we are arranging in order to flow the water from the upper header to the down header. And during the flow of water, the gases are flowing over the tubes and the gaseous energy we are absorbing with the help of feed water, and feed water is converting into steam. That steam we are using in our application. And in this type of boiler, the steam also generated in the boiler drum itself. Inside the boiler drum itself, the steam also generated. Here only the steam is generated. Steam generation space. From the steam generation space, we are collecting the generated steam. That steam we are introducing into our applications. And during the conversion of feed water into steam, if there is any level decreases on the boiler drum, we have to compensate the level of water inside the boiler drum. This is the schematic arrangement of the Babcock and Wilcox boiler. It is one of important type of boiler into your JNDK examinations. See the working principle. Babcock and Wilcox boiler is a horizontal and externally fired and natural circulation and stationary type of water tube boiler. Water flows inside the tubes and it is a natural circulation. Due to the gravity difference only we are circulating the water, and hot flue gases are generated outside the combustion chamber, outside the boiler. That gases we are introducing into the boiler section. The drum is connected to the headers. We are arranging the upper headers and down headers through the drum. From the drum through the headers, we are introducing the feed water. Furnace is heated below the uptake header. Baffles we are arranging. One of the important term, what is baffles? With the help of baffle plates, we are increasing the heat transfer time between the flue gases and water, flowing water. We are increasing the time of heat transfer between the hot flue gases and water with the help of a baffle plates. If you make obstructions with the help of baffles, you can increase the heat transfer rate from the hot flue gases to the feed water. Okay, water from the drum enters into the bottom header and flows through the tubes. Okay, always water is flowing inside the tubes and hot flue gases flows over the tubes. Okay, and water is converting into steam. After utilizing the gaseous energy, okay, that gases are escaped into the outside atmosphere through the chimney. Okay, in that manner, okay, we are generating the steam, okay, in case of Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Okay, next see the two important types of high pressure boilers. Okay, we are having two different types of high pressure boilers. Okay, one is low mount boiler and second one is Benson boiler. One is low mount boiler and second one is Benson boiler. Okay, in case of low mount boiler, see the construction of low mount boiler here. It is a schematic arrangement of low mount boiler. Okay, in case of Benson boiler, okay, we are using these two boilers for increasing the quality of steam and quantity of steam also. Okay, here no need to construct a drum. Okay, without a drum, we are generating the high pressure and good quality steam, that is the Benson boiler. Okay, with the use of boiler drum, we are generating the steam, that is the low mount boiler. These two are the very, very important type of high pressure boilers. Okay, with the help of these high pressure boilers, we are generating the steam. Okay, see here, in case of low mount boiler, okay, here you have to observe the circulation. Okay, the gaseous direction and water flow direction you have to identify. First you see the number of components in the low mount boiler. Okay, see, this is the steam separating drum. Okay, inside the boiler drum we are generating the steam, and that boiler drum contains of water. Okay, that water is circulating with the help of a feed water pump. Okay, with the help of feed water pump we are circulating the feed water. Okay, and the feed water is entering into the radiate type of evaporator. Okay, evaporator means it is one heat exchanger. Okay, through the heat exchanger, okay, we are sending the feed water to the boiler section, and with the help of that evaporator as a heat exchanger, we are converting partially the partial quantity of heat to the feed water. Okay, in the evaporator section we are adding the heat, and during the circulation process itself, that water is heated and hot water is enters into the economizer tubes. Okay, here also another convective evaporator we are arranging. Okay, with the help of convective evaporator, okay, again we are heating the water, and finally after generating the steam in the convective evaporator, okay, that generated steam enters into the boiler drum. Okay, in the boiler drum, okay, we are collecting the steam, generated steam we are collecting from the boiler drum. Okay, and that generated steam we are introducing into the superheated tubes. Okay, generated steam we are introducing into the superheated tubes. Okay, after the heating the generated steam in the superheated tubes, okay, that steam, superheated steam enters into the point of application. Here we are arranging, I mentioned the prime mover. Okay, with the help of prime mover, okay, we are operating the turbine. Okay, you see here also we are arranging the economizer. Okay, heat of hot flue gases we are transferring to the feed water with the help of three heat exchangers. Here we are using, first we are heating the feed water in the economizer section. Later we are heating the feed water in radiant type of evaporator. Later we are heating in convective evaporator. Okay, we are having different modes of heat transfers. Okay, next semester, okay, you may learn the other subject, heat transfer. Okay, there are different types of different modes of heat transfers: conduction heat transfer, convection heat transfer, and radiation heat transfer. Okay, we are arranging the type of heat exchangers into the raw mount boiler. Okay, first we are heating the feed water in the economizer section. We are already discussed in previous classes. Okay, in boiler accessories section, okay, we are using economizer in order to increase the feed water temperature up to the saturation temperature. Okay, we are heating the feed water up to the saturation temperature. Okay, in case of economizer section. Okay, after heating the feed water in the economizer section, okay, that hot water enters into the radiant evaporator. Okay, in the radiant evaporator, okay, we are again heating the hot water, and again we are rising the temperature of water. And in convective evaporator, again we are heating the feed water, and we are converting that hot water into steam. Okay, in that manner, okay, we are heating the feed water in the boiler section. And how do we supply the quantity of heat to the feed water means, okay, over the tubes we are made to flow the generated hot flue gases. Okay, in this type of tubular construction devices, inside the solid boiler we are arranging all these devices. Okay, and in case of economizer tubes, okay, during the flow of water into the economizer tubes, okay, some quantity of heat energy is transferred into the water, and in the economizer section we are generating the steam. And in case of radiant evaporator, okay, we are adding the some quantity of heat, and again we are increasing the temperature of water. And in case of convective evaporator, again we are increasing the feed water temperature, and feed water is converting into steam. Okay, the generated steam we are introducing into the steam turbine blades, and between the steam turbine blades we are made to expanding the steam turbine, and during the expansion of steam, okay, some power we are receiving from the steam turbine blades. Okay, in that manner we are made to flow the hot flue gases over the tubes, and after utilizing the gaseous energy inside the boiler shell with the help of these accessories, okay, these the tubular construction devices, okay, that gases we have to introduce into the outside atmosphere through the chimney. Okay, after utilization of gaseous energy in all these three devices, and here also we have arranged one air preheater device. Okay, in case of air preheater, okay, we are heating the outside atmospheric air, okay, before introducing it into the boiler combustion chamber with the help of gases escaped into the outside atmosphere through the chimney. Okay, with the help of exhaust gases we are heating the outside atmospheric air in air preheater device. Okay, in case of air preheater, okay, we are heating the outside atmospheric air, okay, with the help of exhaust gases temperature. Okay, after heating, okay, that hot air is entering into the boiler combustion chamber. Okay, in the boiler combustion chamber, okay, we are again generating the combustion products. Okay, that combustion products will help us, okay, to heat the feed water in the heat exchanger section, economizer section, radiant evaporator section, and convective evaporator section. We are heating the feed water. Okay, in that manner we are operating the low mount boiler. Okay, this is the working principle of low mount boiler. Okay, in case of low mount boiler, we are arranging the number of heat exchangers. Okay, over the tubes we are made to flow the gases, inside the tubes we are made to flow the feed water, and during the circulation of feed water inside the tubes, water is getting heated and converting into steam. Okay, in order to utilize the generated gaseous energy, we are made to flow the gases over the tubes, and in order to increase the heat transfer rate, we are arranging the number of horizontal tubes. Okay, after utilizing the gaseous energy, that gases are need to be enters into the outside atmosphere. We have to introduce that gases into the outside atmosphere through the chimney. Okay, before introducing the gases into the outside atmosphere, we are heating the atmospheric air. Okay, we are introducing atmospheric air into the boiler combustion chamber for generating the combustion products. Okay, with the help of a air preheater. Okay, with the help of air preheater, we are heating the outside atmospheric air. Okay, with the help of that air preheater only we can increase the combustion efficiency. We have already discussed the boiler accessories. Okay, in case of low mount boilers, here we are using the boiler accessories. Those are feed water pump, and super heater and air preheater. Okay, these are the boiler accessories to increase the efficiency of the boiler. Okay, with the help of boiler accessories only we can increase the efficiency of the boiler section. Okay, it is a water free boiler. Okay, water free is flowing inside the tubes. High pressure boiler, forced circulation boiler. Forced circulation means we are arranging the pump. Okay, with the help of pump we are sending the water. Okay, we are increasing the pressure of the pump. Mostly we are preferring the centrifugal pump. Okay, the feed water passes through the economizer, and during the circulation of water through the economizer, it increases the water up to the saturation temperature. Okay, later pump delivers the feed water to the evaporator tubes. Okay, water is heated first in the radiant evaporator, next in the convective evaporator. Later it generates the steam in the boiler drum. Okay, from the boiler drum we are collecting the generated steam with the help of a superheater tubes. Okay, that superheater tubes again heats the generated steam, and superheated temperature increases. Superheating quality of steam increases, then that quality of steam is entering into the steam turbine, and from the steam turbine, okay, we are producing the power. The water is evaporated in the tubes, and mixture of water and steam enters the drum. Okay, see, the mixture of water and steam enters into the drum. Here we are using the boiler drum. Okay, that is the difference between low mount and Benson boiler. Okay, the steam is separated in the drum and then the drawn through the superheater. Okay, steam flowing through the superheater tubes is superheated by absorbing the heat of the hot flue gases. And air preheaters heated the outside atmospheric air. It is designed to produce, this type of boiler is designed to produce 45,000 kilogram of steam, to generate 45 kilogram of superheated steam per hour. It generates the 45,000 kilogram of superheated steam per hour. Okay, the pressure of the boiler is generally 125 bar. After 100 bar it is a high pressure boiler, after 100 bar it is a medium pressure boiler. So for heating temperature also we can generate up to the 500 degree centigrade temperature, we can generate the steam. Okay, up to 500 degree centigrade super heating temperature we are heating the generated steam in the super heater tubes. Okay, next let's see the Benson boiler. Okay, Benson boiler. In case of Benson boiler also we are using the same type of heat exchangers, but the arrangement of components, that means construction details are different. Here we are not using the boiler drum. Okay, here we are not using any boiler drum. Okay, here we are using, without using the boiler drum, we are circulating the feed water, and during a single pass. Okay, in a single pass, okay, the water is converting into steam. In case of Benson boiler, in a single pass, water is converting into steam. Okay, see the construction of Benson boiler. Okay, similar to the low mount boiler, here also we are using the air preheater. Okay, with the help of blower, we are sucking the outside atmospheric air that is considered as cold air. That cold air is heated in the air preheater with the help of exhaust gases temperature, and that hot air we are introducing into the boiler combustion chamber, and inside the boiler combustion chamber, okay, we are producing the combustion products. That combustion products we are utilizing in order to heat the feed water. Okay, with the help of radiant evaporator, okay, we are heating the feed water. And in case of convective evaporator and economizer also will help us in order to increase the temperature of feed water. Okay, first we are sending the water from the hot well with the help of a feed water pump to the economizer section. Okay, in the economizer section, we are heating the feed water and with the help of economizer, okay, we are heating and the feed water is converting into hot water. Okay, after passing the water through the economizer, okay, it enters into the radiant evaporator. Okay, after passing the water into the radiant evaporator tubes, okay, it enters into the convective evaporator. Okay, in case of convective evaporator, it is converting into steam. And after generating the steam, that the generated steam is introducing into the superheater. Okay, after generating the superheater, heated steam, okay, with the help of superheaters, okay, inside the superheater tubes also, we are made to flow the generated superheated steam. Okay, that superheated steam is, okay, entering into the steam turbines. Okay, in that manner, we are, okay, producing the superheated steam in the Benson boiler. Okay, what is the difference between Benson boiler and previous law mount boiler is, here we are not using the boiler drum, there we are using the boiler drum. Okay, here in a single pass we are generating the steam, there we required some additional heat exchangers in order to produce the steam. Here also we are generating the superheating steam, there also we are generating the superheated steam. Okay, Benson boiler there is no drum, completely eliminated. It employs forced circulation and steam is generated in the single pass. Okay, feed water at high pressure is circulated through the economizer. With the help of economizer, we are generating the hot water, and the hot water is sent to the evaporator, radiant evaporator tubes, and it is converting into steam. The generated steam is, we are heating in the superheater section, and it is converting into superheated steam. That superheated steam we are introducing into the prime mover, and from the prime mover we are producing the work output. And generated steam pressure is 225 bar, and we are using this type of boiler for 1035,000 kilogram per hour of steam we are generating. Okay, these are the different types of boilers we are using in the steam power plants. Okay, thank you.